The Grains Research and Development Corporation's Water Use Efficiency Initiative has been recognised for its contribution to agriculture. The initiative, which set out to deliver a minimum 10% increase in grain yields through the more efficient use of soil water, has been awarded CSIRO's prestigious 2013 medal for impact from science.
Crop production in Australia, most of Australia, certainly southern Australia, is largely limited by water availability. So if you're using it 10% more efficiently, that in the majority of years that's a 10% increase in yield. And if you can do that by a technique that doesn't cost you anything or only cost you a little bit, that's a 10% increase in profit, essentially. So it's hugely significant.
CSIRO's James Hunt coordinated the R&D program, in which GRDC invested $17.6 million over 5 years. Across southern and western grain regions, CSIRO, state agencies and regional grower groups collaborated on 16 projects. This New South Wales trial looked at summer fallow weed management.
Here we're in the plot where the weeds just went mad. We didn't control any of them. Fairly tight. You know, we're getting around that 45, 50 centimetre penetration. Whereas here we're in the complete weed control. You know, obviously we've got a full profile of moisture still.
A major conclusion drawn from the overall initiative was that managing the pre-crop period is essential in preparing soils to capture, store and retain water for a subsequent crop. Another project matched fertiliser inputs to soil types in southern Australia's Mallee country, while in WA the addition of gypsum to southern coast soils improved water use efficiency, resulting in better crop yields. And in Victoria, break crops, especially legumes, were trialled to determine how they could enhance yield and more efficient water use.
The method was to consider trying to get different crops back into the system that would also help fix nitrogen and leave more moisture for the following year's wheat crop.
In southern New South Wales, the sowing of slow-maturing wheat varieties into stored soil moisture was the focus of another of the initiative's projects. Those trials found the practice produced an average yield gain of 0.8 tonnes a hectare, while another measured the impact of grazing cereal stubbles.
As long as you obey those rules, which are that you always control summer weeds and you always keep 70% of cover on paddocks at all times, you'll still get good fallow efficiency, so 70% cover is enough to prevent wind erosion, water erosion, and maximise infiltration. So as long as you do that, you can graze sheep on stubbles.
As a result of these and other projects undertaken as part of GRDC's National Water Use Efficiency Initiative, many grain growers have already started to change practices and begun improving crop yields. The initiative has also shown that in those years when soil moisture is not a limiting factor, the additional benefits of fixing nitrogen or earlier sowing are farming system practices that will contribute to improved returns. A 10% increase in yields through improved water use efficiency was the target. The results have been far better, and CSIRO's recognition of the initiative's success is acknowledgement of RD&E well done.